Now, Australian Women's Basketball World Cup plan is back on track after the Opals defeated Serbia 69-54 last night and absolutely mauled Mali on Friday. The win was in no small part due to the career comeback of our greatest player of all time, Lauren Jackson, who joins us now from Sydney Olympic Park. Lauren, it's so great to speak to you today. The Opals, they were beaten by Serbia on the last two occasions they faced them. This must have been a sweet victory.
Yeah, I think it was. You know, obviously we had to win last night and the girls really stepped up and played incredible basketball. So it was a lot of fun to be a part of. And, you know, we're just getting such great crowds out here. It's been a lot of fun.
Key player Beck Allen suffered an injury towards the end of the match. Do we know how she's going?
Yeah, I think, look, Beck's in a bit of pain at the moment. Not 100% sure what the exams have said, but we'll find out pretty soon, I think.
Lauren, it's Lachie Kennedy here. I started my journalism career in Wind News Canberra, covering the sport, where you were smashing it for the Canberra Capitals. One of the greats. Off to Seattle you went. Yeah. You are the GOAT. You retired 6 years ago. The basketball world is in mourning. You've come back. It is the greatest sporting comeback of all time. How does it feel? It is. I'm saying it right now, and I'm a journalist, trust me. How do you feel about it? Why did you want to give your career a second go? And thankfully you did.
Oh, look, you know, last year the timing was just right. My children, my eldest went back to started school and my youngest is in daycare. So I had a bit of time up my sleeve and work. But look, I work with Basketball Australia and they sort of said, look, if you want to take some time in the morning to go and work out and, you know, because I sort of made mention that I want to get fit again and stuff. They're like, go and do it, you know. You can work in the afternoon. So I got a bit of flexibility and... you know, for me, it was a bit of a win-win because regardless, I was going to get fit again, you know. So that was a great opportunity for me. And I just, you know, it was day by day. And, I got back out on court, which I did not think was going to happen. And then I don't even know how it happened. I can't even tell you. But it's incredible and it's a real honour.
Well, you first played for the Opals 25 years ago. So to be back out there in the green and gold, do you feel more pressure or a little bit less this time around?
No, I feel less. It's for me at the moment, like I said, it's just a dream come true. It's for me, I guess I'm in a very different headspace to what I was when I was leading the Opals. You know, I'm not playing a huge amount of minutes and my role is literally just to sort of pick up minutes here and there where the big girls need a break. So I go out there and I get to bang a little bit and play a bit of defense. It's fun. Like, I'm enjoying it. It's a great role and I definitely don't feel the pressure that I used to feel. So it makes it a lot easier.
Are you feeling the injuries that you used to feel? How's the body holding up now?
Well, pretty good because I haven't had to play a lot of minutes. So, like, I'm sort of, you know, at a 10 to 15 minute mark, really. And it's... you know, it's been pretty good. So, like, fingers crossed, things, you know, keep going to plan. But, like I said, just really enjoying it. And it's, yeah, really proud because I get to play in front of my kids and my family and then obviously in front of Australia, which is just so special.
It takes one sprint to injure me, by the way.
This World Cup, as you say,
Lauren...
It used
to do that to me as well.
This World Cup, as you say, is being played in our backyard. And obviously the Opals team is about rebuilding its culture at the moment. As you say, you're not playing the greatest amount of minutes like you used to, but what role do you think you are playing at getting the Opals back up there? Are you mentoring a lot of the younger players?
I think... I bring a little bit of toughness and a little bit of grit, I think, to the girls. And I think that's something that it's fun. You know, it's a great role to play. I think, you know, obviously I'm not as athletic as I used to be. So to be able to get out there and bang a little bit and just get the girls fired up, you know, it's a great role for me. And I think, yeah, I'm happy to play it. I'm happy to do whatever I'm told to do, obviously.
well, anything you can do is going to be a benefit to people. Like you said, you're the GOAT, you know, and people will look to you, look for inspiration from you as well. So can you tell us about your new project, She Hoops, and what's that all about?
Yeah, so She Hoops is really exciting. It's an initiative that Basketball Australia are getting underway this week. We're launching this week. And, yeah, it's basically about empowering and leading women in basketball, so referees, officials, coaches, administrators. It's a platform where we can educate people and just really bring everyone together and create a women in basketball community, so from grassroots to the elite. And it's really exciting, so look out for that. It's shehoops.com.au, and we will be launching this year.
This week,
my brain's all over.
You've got another big game tonight. You're playing Canada. How are you feeling about it?
We do. Look, Canada have been playing great basketball, and they are a big team. So, you know, I think we feel pretty positive that, you know, we're getting better each game. We know what we have to do to win, and I think the girls too, after our first game that we lost, we know that we've got to come out ready to fight each game, you know, and bring our A game. So we'll give it everything we have. I'm not sure Beck will be playing tonight, but I think that, you know, we've got enough firepower to get the win.
There we go. And we know you do too. Every time we see our name on the team sheet, we're golden. The Women's Basketball World Cup continues this week with the final on Saturday. The Opals play Canada at 8:30 tonight. Don't miss it. Find details about tickets and how to watch at the address on your screen. Lauren Jackson, it's been such a pleasure to speak to you. Good luck tonight, and thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks for everything you do for basketball.
Thank you very much.